everyone. I hope everyone is doing okay. This is going to be a little bit of a different one. I don't know whether I'm going to stay on for, because obviously I've got yesterday to make up for, because we were out and about for the first time in a while. And so yeah, by the time we came home and I got stuff sorted, we just didn't have time to get anything done. We didn't get time to actually get anything filming-wise done. So my original plan was to do about an hour and a half again to make up for Sunday, and an hour and a half tomorrow to make up for the other half of Sunday. I'll do 45 minutes in the morning and 45 minutes in the afternoon, or an hour and half an hour, depending on how we got on. And then I switched on to Facebook and saw that one of my neighbours, we believe, has been marked to say that they have a dog in the house. She kindly put up a photograph on our community Facebook group and was like, you know, has anybody had anything similar? And I obviously went out to check our house, our drain pipe, and lo and behold, we had two very distinct marks that were higher than what a car could make. I'm 5'10", 5'11", and I had to basically reach up to get it. Has really thrown me off. You know, I then spent pretty much the rest of the morning outside with different members of my neighbours, different people, kind of like discussing marks that were on their drain pipes, discussing marks that we had, because we also had some like zigzag marks along with the two horizontal lines. We think that the horizontal lines are purely there because of when they were fitting the drain pipes in, that they've obviously had to wiggle them in, etc., and that's kind of where they've come from. But we're not sure, so we are basically, you know, kind of keeping an eye on things. I've just purchased some security cameras for the house. We're hoping to get one on the side gate, one on one as the doorbell, which is motion detected, and then depending on how we go, we might get one for the back garden as well. And it's just kind of knocked me for six. It's kind of really shook me, because you know, I don't want the thought of knowing that. So like, my mum had messaged and was like, the shops are open, do you need to get anything for Isaac? And I was like, well, yeah, I do. You know, there's a lot of things that I need to get for Isaac, and I just don't feel comfortable leaving the house now, because I'm like, what happens if I go out and I don't have, thank you, and you know, I don't, oh hello, and I don't have a dog to go back to. So it has kind of knocked me for six a little bit at the moment. I imagine that once I get some security set up, etc., I will probably feel a lot better. But I don't know. It's not nice. It's not nice thinking that, you know, your house has been marked for whatever reason. Go on, swim to it. Oh, yes. Nice. So yeah, that's why there's been no pet of the day. It is just of Isaac. You know, I'm not... So I am sorry that this isn't probably as good. This probably isn't going to be as good as some of my other ones, but... Yeah, I'm just... I'm not good. I am not good. I'm sure it's fine. Like I'm sure that it's just like maybe a kid prattling about. Once we move to it, let's move to it, let's move to it. Really got to end with this. Oh, come on, you're right next to it. I'm gonna come back to ducks. Ducks, ducks, ducks. Yeah, like I'm hoping that it's nothing. It is just something that's happened. It's someone prattling about, and they've just decided to freak everyone out. According to somebody who's in the group, you know, they have basically said that their friend has had a look at the zigzag marks at least, and has said that the zigzag marks are more likely due to the them fitting the pole, which I'm in two minds about. I'm not 100% sure, because a part of me is like, all right, okay, yeah, that's probably f Ooh, no, what's going on? I was like, a part of me is like, yeah, that is probably true. You know, that is probably the case, that it is just that. You know, it's just they've screwed it in, and we've been in for so long now that it's had that much rain, etc., etc., that it is now starting to bring up these marks, and we just haven't noticed them before because we've not really had a need to look for them. You know, because essentially we haven't, you know, we've never needed to look before. Oh. Yeah, we've never really felt the need to constantly be looking at like what's going on in our neighbour's house, and you know, marks on our drain pipes, and you know, we've been in the house now for know, we've been in the house for a long time. Afraid to see if that's anywhere near, don't it? Wait until they. Yeah, I am very much hoping that it is just essentially a case of it's something else, or some kids have decided, oh, you know, it'll be really funny, let's put some marks on a gate. But we've had a lot of like instances recently of people feeling unsafe when they've been walking their dogs. You know, people, you know, a couple of weeks ago there was a pictures of a woman who had had it attempted to take her. Hey. my face. Let's swing by a statue of seven. Yeah, they'd attempted to they cut her lead and tried to take her dog, and she had like cut marks all on her arm where they'd basically gone at her with a knife, trying to get her to leave the dog. But it's a very sad time when you can't even leave your dog just for a few minutes. Sorry, somebody else has put something else up. You've got two dogs, nothing else. But... Okay. So, some people are obviously noting, like, some people have had squiggles on theirs, and they're like, we don't have a dog. Some people like us have had both. I think what's done a lot of us is the fact that it's not on every drain pipe, and it's very inconsistent. So, for instance, the only pipe that's been affected for us has been the one where we've had the mark on. The two definite scratches. Some people don't have dogs and have them. Some people have only got one. Some people only have the two horizontal marks. So it's kind of difficult. Is that it? Okay. Well, that wasn't very clear. Sweet. Yeah, so it's just been very very uncertain times for us at the moment, and it's been very very stressful. Very very stressful. But on a lighter note, his new boxing gloves have arrived. He started teething again. Even the nursery noted that he was starting to get a lot of teeth through together. So we brought him his first boxing glove. They were three to 6 months, not 6 months. And they were great because obviously, you know, it had the teething part in it, and it was on his hands, and he did kind of use them a lot. But then his hands started getting a bit too big, and he started realizing how he could take it off, and we just stopped using them. I ended up throwing, there's like a little hoop thing. I think he's holding onto that with his other hand at the moment. I think he's using that to kind of like help him chew it, which is not what it's intended for, but that's fine. We'll take what we can get, won't we? Yeah, we will, Tiki Jackie. Yeah, we will, Tiki Jackie. And I ended up putting them in the bag that came with it. It had like a little washing bag with it. And I ended up throwing the bag away. Because I am an idiot. Oh, change the journaling for this. No, go off. Maybe jangling wasn't the best one for this. But yeah, so I ended up throwing essentially half of it away. By accident, I put it back in the box, and then forgotten that I'd put it back in the box. And so, yeah, I obviously, being the recycling person that I am, I chucked the box away because I'm an idiot. And so it got lost. And I was gonna get a new one, and then I just kind of forgot. And then it was just like, well, it's gonna be really weird and embarrassing. Like, hi, yeah. We love your thing, but I threw half of it away. Can I order another one, please? Exactly. Your mummy's daft. Where's the two here? Where are they? Ah, okay. I'm a bit too high up. Go to that one. Actually, we might as well just do this one first. Is it nearby? Looks like it's nearby. Ooh. Is it on here? Might be on here. It is there. Oh, I am on the wrong team for this. Come on. Thank you. Totally got the wrong team for this. Oh, maybe not. I was actually okay. I mean, Mona nearly died, but yeah, she's fine. She's a tough girl, it's like Mona. But yeah, so understandably, it just freaked me out, and I just spent the entire morning basically just like not letting Rufus out, just speaking to different neighbours to see whether, you know, have they seen anything, what is it? That's not that one. Oh yeah, because I went up here, didn't I? I was going to say, but that one is a thing, so I will change to what's the name, or what's the face. Change. Yeah, and then obviously I came here in, and then Isaac was asleep, so I didn't have part to wake him up because it looks so adorable when he's asleep. I was like, it's such a horrible time to just exist at the moment, because you know you can't. I mean, one of the things that I was potentially looking forward to was being able to take Rufus for a walk. We've been feeling really bad and feeling really neglectful lately because we've not taken him for a walk for a while because the weather's not been great, and obviously I can't take Isaac and Rufus together. So my hope was, oh, well, now the weather's getting a bit better, I'll have a look at taking him. You know, I'll have Isaac in. We brought like a little lighter pram. So I was like, oh, I'll have a look. You know, I've got a leash belt for Rufus. Should be fine. And now, I mean, even the police were like, don't go for a walk on your own. And it is kind of like, it's not fair to Rufus. It's not. I mean, it's not fair to us either, but it is not, it's not really unfair to basically have to keep your dogs locked in the house constantly because you're terrified that someone is going to break in and steal them. This is my rant of today. And I do apologise, Facebook. I do apologise. I don't mean to be such a grump. Apparently I knocked it out of its thing, that's fine. You know, I feel awful for Rufus. I just feel like now we just live in a time where everybody is so frightened to do anything, and it's not completely COVID's fault, because you know, it's not COVID's fault, but people are deciding to steal other people's pets. Hey, you pulled that dog, you naughty man. You know, it's not COVID's fault that people have decided that they're just going to take a one look at dogs and be like, right, I'm just going to steal that for myself because I am a word I can't say while I'm on Facebook for what is supposedly a dog charity. And then I think about all these dogs that end up getting found and abandoned and things like that, and I'm like, you know, were any of you dogs that have been stolen, was there anybody looking out for you? That I need to stop, because it's frustrating me and it's upsetting me, and it's not a good combination of things to be doing. This is a combat one, so I am going to switch back to Shangri, bless her. No, I meant to brush you. So instead, I'm going to take my aggression on these abyss mages. Yeah. I'm absolutely freezing now because I've spent so long outside. And it's cold. Well, I should have sat 3 of 7. Yes, I should have. You are quite right, Chadling baby. How bad am I for health? I should be fine. Aimless last words. I think I feel better once things are installed and, you know, we're getting one of those Ring doorbell things, because they've been proven to work quite well. And like I said, we're going to have a camera on the side of the house and then a camera on the back, and should make us feel a little bit more safe. And now I'm hoping now that, because people are aware of it, and you know, I've sanded the marks down from the drain pipe and wiped them off.
Run away.
Run away! No, thank you. I hear what you say, but I do not appreciate it. Thank you. Where is this thing? Is it down here? It's down there. Whee! I should be careful, because I often forget to, like, bring my wings back out. Thank you. And now I feel bad because anytime I hear any kind of noise outside my house, I feel like I'm smashed up against the window. Like, who are you? What are you doing? What are you doing in my house? I mean, like, there was a blue car that pulled up earlier, and I was like, he probably was just, like, moving out of the way or something. I always got the wrong house. But, you know, I was like, no, no. Oh, that was a nice stop off there. Looks like he's going to absolutely throw it down. But yeah, we had a lovely walk. We went around the reservoir near where we live. We met up with two friends who also have a beautiful little girl. And it was just really great to see them. It was great to not have to wear a mask and not feel like, because obviously we were outside. And obviously we maintain social distancing, so it was really great just to be able to meet up with other people and not feel like we are breaking some sort of rule and feeling horrible and just being like, oh my god, we're going to get reported. And to go out and have a coffee, like the coffee thing was on site, so... So glad I did this now. I'm so glad I didn't wait. Even if I did end up doing like supposedly one of the hardest quests completely by accident. So if you remember last time, I went through. Yeah, so I went through and I ended it on quest called, I think it's like the Trials of Shanguin or something like that, that was kind of centered around here. And I had heard so many horror stories of this challenge, of it taking people weeks to do, and I just wanted to get the time challenges out of the way and had no idea. And because I'm only world level one and I'm at the highest point, like, it is telling me I can't get any higher character level wise. I have to ascend my world in order to do it. It actually wasn't so bad. Like, I, as you guys saw, I finished it relatively quickly and I was just like, I'm not gonna die on a hill of making sure that I have to only do it via on my own. I was like, I'm not putting myself through that. If somebody has took the time to make a guide to help me out, I'm gonna use it. Yeah, so I was like, I'm not going to be one of these people that spends weeks in order to do things. I imagine like a lot of these people was probably before the guide was created, and it's probably because of this hassle they went through that they created the guide. I was like, I'm not being that person. If you're going to write me a guide, I'm going to follow it. I know within like the first 10 minutes or so whether I am going to have a horrendous time doing this. And if I am, gonna have it, I'm not putting myself through that. I'm sorry, I know that means I'm not a real gamer. But there we go. That is the hill I will die on. I will die on the hill that means that I can follow Jesus if I need to. I feel sorry for Isaac because I have basically abandoned him all day. Oh no, I am the, this is the wrong person to have. Don't fall off, don't fall off, don't fall off. I could not have got that anymore at the skin of my teeth if I genuinely tried. Ooh. Well. That's that one then. Let's get back up here. You can stop bashing, I'm nowhere near it now. Let's figure out where that is. It's going to be all the way down. Oh my god, it is. Oh, it's there though. That's not too bad. I thought it would be all the way down there. That is not so bad. I know you were just, but I can see you getting in the way. And I'm sorry about that. Why can I not? Oh no 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 no! Well, that's horrible. I don't like that. No, we don't like that, do we? No, see, even the baby agrees. No. No. Horrible place to put that. Just like generally a horrible place to put that. See what? That's something went up there, doesn't mean off that side too. No, just this side. Okay. So that's that one. Where is that? I don't know if I can see that. Would help if I was facing the right way. You don't necessarily want to jump off if it's not actually. Let's go like this one. Thank you. don't want to mess with that. Didn't see a thing. You saw nothing. You genuinely did, to be fair. So done that one. Look. There's so many combat trials. Ooh, why do I continue to use the wrong characters for this? Change characters for the love of Jim Belushi. There you go, that's one down. So slow when it wants to be. Change characters! Why do I keep doing this in like with 1 second to spare? Instead of, I don't know, just getting the right characters. I'm not doing well, folks. I'm not doing well at all. I'm hoping my hubby's going to take pity on me and let me have some sweets today. I very much doubt it, but... I'm not an Eye of the Storm. What? Since when do you live there? You're not even in Mondstadt. Kindly go. Kindly go. Kindly go. Just go. Thank you. This can't be right. I feel like I've made a terrible mistake here. Oh no! Oh no! I'm stealing your thing anyway. Thank you. where's the control? That's weird. I like her. No, because I'm moving further away from it. What? You should stop jumping. I'm gonna die now because of this. Me and my stupid jumping. No, I'm just gonna teleport back to the teleport, so why am I doing this to myself? Alright. Is it further up? I thought it was lower down than this. It's a challenge fail, didn't it? Oh, I'm at the wrong one, that's why. It's over there, though. I'm looking for the one. But that brings an interesting point about where the other one is. Where is the other one? Who is this hand? Okay, such challenges. Helps if you don't push forward as you're doing it. Don't you dare, don't you dare, don't you dare. Oh my gosh. Don't mind me, heavy child. Where's it gone now? Did it continue to fall? Are you kidding me? Has it seriously just fallen off there? Is it? That's very frustrating. What happened to that? That's it's there. Oh, I suppose that does actually make sense, doesn't it? Because obviously it's dropped off there, so as it's dropped off, what a stupid thing. Tell you guys, I'm not doing well today. I'm not. I feel like I just need to under the cliff. Next to the shore, so it's like all the way down. Oops. Right, so you can go. I'm desperately trying not to wake that up. I mean, it's up, but like, trigger it to my presence. Because that is not going to be fun. I'm using some turtle earths again, just to get out of the way. Am I all healed? Thanks! But yeah, so back to my main point. I know that I said I was going to stop talking about it, and I am in an aggressive, frustrated way. Check things around your property. I'm not saying every day, but kind of like say once a week, and try and incorporate into your morning routine. Because if something like this does end up happening to you, the problem that we've had is because obviously we don't go out and check our drains constantly, our drain pipes, I should say. We weren't incredibly helpful for the police when we phoned up. Well, when I phoned up, because it was like, okay, well, when did you notice this? And I was like, well, to be honest, if it wasn't for this woman posting it on one of our neighbours posting it on the community group on Facebook, because it was like, I never would have checked. And I was like, so the only time I can really tell you is it's not been. I don't even know why I'm bothering to carry on. Because I don't have a claymore, you deserve. But now I do, and it's gonna go very differently than last time. But yeah, so what was I going to say? Sorry, I got distracted. The only problem is that if it's something that I feel like I really need to concentrate on, I am terrible at just kind of like just shutting it down for a minute and being like, right, okay, well, I can still do this on top at the same time. I am the stereotypical man who cannot multitask. But yeah, so maybe once a week, just go and have a quick look out, make sure that, you know, that there's no chalk drawings on or around your property. Check your drain pipes, make sure that they haven't been tampered with. Check for chalk drawings as well. We have a window cleaner who comes around, and I don't know whether that's why they've targeted our drain pipe as opposed to our chalk around our door, because obviously when our window cleaner comes around, he cleans the door and therefore will clean off anything that has appeared. So they give you like how long to do that? So I had 20 seconds spare, but like some of the other ones, it's no, you get over there now. Actually, there isn't. I wonder if I can. Can I open that? I probably don't. Yeah, I probably can't. Oh no, I can. Hey. I mean, I don't need to go in there or anything. Yeah, it's nice to have a teleport link open. But yeah, so check your properties regularly, particularly if you have dogs. If you don't have dogs but you do spot any unusual things, take photographs of it, send it to the police, alert your neighbours as well, because if the police are attempting to create a bit more of an insight into the area, then you know they will link them together as they have done with us. We have basically were given the crime number, and they said to us anything that kind of happens in the future, just quote us this and we will link it all together. So instead of having, I mean, there's more than 38 houses on our estate, but if instead of having 38 individual cases, we've now got one case with 38 different examples. Even if it turns out to be nothing, even if it does turn out to be that, you know, your partner has backed into the backed the car into the drain pipe or something ridiculous like that, it's better to warn them and be told it's nothing than to not and lose a pet. I did accidentally press that one. I didn't mean to bring normal. So the annoying thing about the achievements in this game is they don't give you an achievement for doing everything. They give you achievement for doing a certain amount. So for instance, with the Mondstadt one, let's use Mondstadt as an example. Oh wow, 8,000. Why is this annoying not telling me how many that you did? Oh no, they were, sorry, that's me. So there are 17 time trial challenges in Mondstadt, but you don't get an achievement to say that you've got all of them. You get one for saying that you've done 15. And it's the same as the Seelies. When it comes to the Seelies, this is the highest one that you get, 40. But there are 52 Seelies in Mondstadt. So it's frustrating because it does kind of feel like like maybe you've done them all and you haven't. So for instance, I know I did that one. So I've done 43, 44, 45, 46, 47. Is there 47? Let me do a quick Google. There are 46. Does that mean I've already done one? Or is one of them repeated? One of them might be repeated. I hope one of them is repeated. But yeah, so you don't get an achievement for doing all 46. You get it for a really random number. So I guess I kind of get it, because you know, if you are struggling to find one Sealy, it is frustrating to basically try and constantly search the map when you could be doing other things. But if you are a completionist, that is of no help. I might unlock that domain while I'm here. So I believe that the time trial is actually in here, where the thing is. I'm like straight across from it. It is. I thought as much. Can I unlock this? Yay! This is gonna save so much fun. Oh! Oh, come on! Ooh. Just. I am far too used to my account when I have a much more powerful razor that kind of deals with all of this for me. Oh dear. Might not be. Time travel with a on the grammar, and it's a column of light to begin a time challenge. Okay. Oh, yeah, that. I think we have to train ourselves for those situations. Mm-hmm. God's sake. Ooh, really? Oh, then I'm gonna have to like zip out of here, aren't I? So does that do that one? There are orbs that occur in this island that you activate to hunt enemies in a time limit. There is a little bit. I mean, they're not awake. Another precious gem. So that is that to do with that. People are wanting to suffer the consequences. Is that so in the insufficiently evil that you should slay your blade? I do believe in excess and meditation, as far as right. Well, I still intend to take on these monsters, even if it means to do so without him, and even if it means to do so without a vision. I don't want to get too close to that island. Monsters are the bane of all that is worth living for in this world. How long are we going to live for? Those of us who are skilled with the blade are duty bound to hunt them down out of existence. Monsters are evil, they deserve nothing more than the merciless slaughter they will get. Okay, so I think there are at least two precious chests and two exquisite chests to obtain on this island. Note, after clearing the orbs, so there's still some around then. Is that what this is saying? And I've got two precious chests, surely. Okay, God. Unless it just means in general. To obtain on this island. So the only thing I can think of is that I have actually done. Let me check the achievements. Forty-six in. Maybe I have to come back? So I can't see anymore. I can't see any on any surrounding island either. Well, hopefully they've not gone to that one, because that island does not look fun. would have thought I've done that one. And there's that one to go. Treasure challenge. There are orbs that appear on this island that you activate to hunt down enemies in a time limit. Room challenge. Interact with the round thing on the ground that emits a column of light to begin a timed challenge, which I did. After clearing the orbs, if you stand in the centre for 2 minutes, a ruin hunter may appear guarding another precious chest, which I've already got. I mean, like, do I have to come back and finish it off? I don't really get the feeling it's on. That island. I feel like that chest is to do with them torches. I'm gonna go ahead and say I've done that one. A seaport. time is it? An hour 15. Bear with me a minute. I'm gonna leave this here because obviously I've just noticed that he's fallen asleep in his thing, and I'm gonna go put him to bed for a little bit. So thank you everybody very much for watching, and yeah, we'll see you in the next one. Bye.